Climate Launchpad is the biggest clean tech business idea competition in Europe. And with over 700 different startups signing up from 28 different countries, it's clear that there's going to be some really, really good ideas on how to curb climate change. I'd like to introduce you to Metin and Ahmed. And you're from?
Belgium.
Flanders.
From Belgium, yes, exactly.
Yes.
And where are you from?
From Austria, but I'm Egyptian.
Good
but
stuff.
I'm representing Austria today.
Representing Austria, that's great. Yeah, we have Solabolic and CO2 Electro Refinery. That's
yes.
The companies that that you guys are representing here today as well. Ahmed, you, what does your solution do?
Okay. Solar thermal power plants basically are the best and perfect alternative to replace fossil fuel power plants.
Mm-hmm.
It's like oil and gas and coal. And basically the problems facing this kind of technology is the high costs and the complicated manufacturing processes.
Right.
And with complicated manufacturing processes, I mean that you need high-tech manufacturing processes to produce this kind of collectors. And these manufacturing processes are not available in many regions in the world,
right.
Especially in the emerging markets.
Mm-hmm.
And on the other side, the greatest resources, the world's greatest resources for solar energy, for this technology, is in the emerging markets and the developing economies.
Right.
So that means there's kind of gap between the technology and the locations for suitable for this technology. And then we come to the game.
Mm-hmm.
We are filling this gap between the technology and the market. And our solution is basically to be able to produce these kind of solar collectors,
mm-hmm.
for the most part anywhere in the world, even
right.
in a desert with simple technicians.
That's
and
cool.
This supports the political decision, especially in the emerging markets,
mm-hmm.
and accelerates the utilization of solar thermal power plants.
And you draw some inspiration from suspension bridges, correct?
Exactly. The idea is basically no one have noticed that some suspension bridges having a perfect parabolic shape in this main in their main cables.
Mm-hmm.
And this perfect parabolic shape is the perfect shape to focus the sunlight.
Okay, great.
And for example, the most conventional and common solar collector has the name of the parabolic trough. And
right.
this is because of this geometrical shape. And we have utilized this geometrical shape, this geometric shape,
mm-hmm.
the parabolic shape, by achieving it with just a physical law, without the need of any high-tech laser cutting systems
right.
or something.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's great. That'll make it a hell of a lot easier, especially in the emerging markets. So you guys have seen some really interesting startups and been through an amazing roller coaster ride to get here. What are the interesting things that you've picked up during this competition?
First and foremost, I have learned that great people is sometimes much more important than high qualified coaches. So
right.
the startup founders are basically inspiring each other in a really natural way,
mm-hmm.
without any kind of coaching sessions and so on. So this is the most important gain.
Mm-hmm.
Of this competition, the great people who I know.
That's great.
Yeah.
Sounds very inspiring. Everybody's inspiring each other.
It's
and
really like this. Yeah.
Seeing all of the great ideas come around and all
yeah,
that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Great. And so you're basically helping the smaller markets that wouldn't otherwise be able to create solar panels and that kind of stuff. So what impact does this have on climate change?
So, for example, we are planning to install about 14 gigawatts,
mm-hmm.
With our technology in capacity by
right.
2030.
Yeah.
And with this capacity, we can save about 80 million tons of CO2 per year. And this is equivalent to the emission of a whole country like Austria, for example. Alternatively, we can, with this capacity, produce fresh water from seawater through seawater desalination with the amount of about 30 billion cubic meter of fresh water. And with this amount, we can supply the whole region of Middle East and North Africa.
Great.
And they have already a fresh water lack right now. So this is an actual problem.
So basically, if you do your job extremely well, then you won't have a market anymore.
This
is the inspiration what I was talking about. Yeah? He has to change his business model.
Well, I think we're a long way away of solving all of the world's problems, but we're definitely getting there. So if you'd like to learn a little bit more about these companies at home or others, say, like you guys said, there's lots of very inspiring startups out there and great stories, then go to the website, climatelaunchpad.eu, and check them out.